With the war dragging on, there are no signs of Assad being toppled, a goal obstinately pursued by the West and its regional allies since early 2011. Many observers say they have every reason to believe that Assad's adversaries have already lost their bet on toppling him, something that was supposed to occur in a matter of weeks or months.
Vous avez bien sûr la Syrie, tragique, qui passe comme ça au second plan de l'actualité parce que d'autres crises prennent le relais. Les choses ne bougent pas. Tragiquement, elles bougent tous les jours sur le terrain parce qu'il y a des morts. Mais la solution que nous espérons, c'est-à-dire la chute de Bachar, la venue au pouvoir de l'alternance, de la coalition, il n'y a pas de signe récent qui soit si positif que cela.
The Syrian Arab Army has retaken Daraya. The Syrian Army has definitely won this. And we're also getting reports that there was a large concentration of mass al-Nusra terrorists in Daraya and that they may have fared very poorly in the last phase of the engagement. That also raises the question, how long can these terrorists go on? That is, they're drawing on a finite pool. The attrition rates among the terrorists are very high. We're told that Tunisians are now being brought in massively, but at a certain point, they're going to run out of terrorists, and at that point, the rebellion may be in big trouble.
The head of Syria's main opposition coalition says he's ready to sit down with representatives of President Bashar al-Assad's government. Muaz al-Khatib extended the offer via his Facebook page to hold talks outside Syria on the condition that thousands of detainees are released. Syrian officials said this week that certain opposition figures could return to Damascus for dialogue without facing charges.
One or more airstrikes, but just what did Israel fire upon inside Syria? An official statement read on Syrian state television said the planes had targeted a defense research facility.
Israeli military jets entered our airspace at dawn and fired on one of our scientific research centers in the Jamraya area of Damascus province.